Hello, I'm Burton Dickey, Chair of Pulmonary Medicine at the MD Anderson Cancer Center in Houston, Texas. My laboratory has been studying airway mucin secretion for nearly 20 years. And before we discuss the current work, it will be helpful to go over a few points about mucus. The left panel of the cartoon illustrates the continuous production of mucus in the conducting airways, which is swept by beating cilia upwards towards the throat, where it is swallowed and disposed in the gastrointestinal tract. In this way, inhaled microbes and particles of dust can be removed from the lungs. The right panel shows a higher magnification image of alternating ciliated and secretory epithelial cells that line the airways. The granules in the secretory cells contain mucins that are packaged dehydrated. Mucins are very large glycoproteins that interact with several hundredfold their mass of water after secretion to form mucus. The mobile mucus barrier is an essential defense of the lungs, as shown by the fact that its deletion in mice results in infection, inflammation, and death. Paradoxically, however, this barrier itself can cause airway obstruction in diseases such as asthma, cystic fibrosis, and COPD by the mechanism illustrated in the following slide. The upper row shows mouse airways cut longitudinally and stained with ABPAS that colors mucins purple. The bottom row shows mouse airways cut in cross-section and fixed with methicarn to keep extracellular mucins in place and then stained with PAFS that colors mucins red. In the left column are naive mouse airways, which show very little intracellular or extracellular mucin. In the middle column are the airways of mice with increased mucin production, often called mucus metaplasia, due to allergic inflammation in an ovalbumin model. In the right column are the airways of mice that underwent mucus metaplasia, then were exposed to an ATP aerosol to stimulate secretion. You can see in the middle column that increased mucin production without stimulated secretion does not cause mucus occlusion of the airway, and that it is only the combination of increased production and stimulated secretion that causes occlusion in the right panel. This cartoon shows a generic airway epithelial exocytic machine based on work from our laboratory and others. Mucins are illustrated in green within the secretory granule on the left, and then on the right are shown expanding as they interact with water to form mucus after fusion of the granule with the plasma membrane. The key players in this machinery are snare proteins, illustrated as black bars. Three snare helices are anchored in the plasma membrane and one in the granule membrane, as shown on the left. These assemble into a four-helix bundle on a Munc18 scaffold, shown in dark blue. In the center, in light blue, is shown the stimulation of secretion by an extracellular agonist such as ATP or acetylcholine, acting on a heptahelical receptor coupled to the trimeric G protein, GQ. This activates phospholipase C beta to generate the second messengers diacylglycerol and calcium that act on Munc13 and synaptotagmin to drive full coiling of the snare complex to induce exocytosis. Our prior work gave hints that the airway epithelium uses two different exocytic machines for baseline and stimulated mucin secretion. To analyze this definitively, we focused on Munc18, which is the scaffold on which the snare complex assembles.
Hi, my name is Ana Maria Jaramillo. I was a graduate student in Dr. Dickey's laboratory when I did the work reported in this article. Munc18 proteins belong to the larger family of SM proteins that help assemble snare complexes. One isoform acts in every step of vesicle traffic. There are four SM proteins in yeast and seven in mammals. Of the seven in mammals, three have been shown to have roles in exocytosis, and those are Munc18 A, B, and C. To study the role of Munc18 proteins in mucin secretion, we assembled a panel of conditional deletant mice for all three isoforms. As Dr. Dickey mentioned, in the naive state, there is very little intracellular mucin in airway epithelial cells, so so a spontaneous mucin accumulation indicates a defect in the baseline secretory machinery. We saw this accumulation in our Munc18A dilutant, as shown in the PAFS stained airway in the top row, which is quantified in panel B. This defect was confirmed by immunoblotting for MUC5B in whole lung tissue in panel C. To study stimulated secretion, we first increased mucin production using the ovalbumin allergic inflammation model shown in the top row of panel A. And then we gave ATP to stimulate mucin secretion shown in the bottom row. You can see that the Munc18B mutant retains more intracellular mucin after the stimulation of secretion, which is quantified in panel B as raw intracellular mucin content, and in panel C as fractional secretion. We next hypothesized that targeting Munc18A, which mediates a stimulated secretion, could alleviate airway mucus occlusion without impairing toxicant clearance, which is mediated by the baseline secretory machinery that includes Munc18A. To test this hypothesis in an asthma model, we started by increasing mucin production with AL13 and then exposing the mice to a methacholine aerosol to stimulate mucin secretion and induce luminal mucus occlusion as shown in the top row. We then compared the sum of the area of luminal mucus across the lungs in panel B and saw that Munc18B dilutant mice had a 60% reduction in luminal mucus compared to their litter mates, which is similar to the protection of knocking out MUC5AC shown in the last bar. Munc18B deletion also protected the mice from airway hyperreactivity to methacholine, a sensitive indicator of asthmatic airway dysfunction as shown in panel C and D. This hypothesis was also tested in a cystic fibrosis model where we crossed our Munc18B deletant mice to the transgenic beta-ENaC overexpressing mouse. Mucus occlusion was again reduced by 60% as measured in panel B, and emphysema was significantly attenuated as measured in panel C. To conclude, the top row illustrates our findings that Munc18A predominates in baseline mucin secretion, where concentrations of intracellular calcium, a key intracellular second messenger for secretion, are low, while Munc18B predominates in stimulated secretion, where concentrations of calciums are elevated in response to high levels of secretagogues. In the top right panel is shown luminal mucus occlusion in response to increased mucin production and stimulated secretion. In the bottom row, it showed the effect of deleting Munc18B to alleviate airway occlusion in muco-obstructive diseases such as asthma and cystic fibrosis, without impairing toxicant clearance that is mediated by Munc18A. In further work, we are attempting to inhibit the stimulated mucin exocytic machine pharmacologically and are determining how the two secreted airway mucins, MUC5AC and MUC5B, are sorted between the baseline and exocytic machine.